Hello, everyone. I'm Dr. Wen. Here is the question. For any real number x, x is not equal to 1 or negative 1. F of x minus 1 over x plus 1 plus f of x plus 3 over 1 minus x equals x. What is the formula of f of x? This is the given equation. We define the inside part of this as a new variable t. T equals x minus 3 over x plus 1. Solving this equation for x in terms of t. We have x equals 3 plus t over 1 minus t. We want to rewrite 3 plus x over 1 minus x in terms of t. We replace x by 3 plus t over 1 minus t here and here. Then we have 3 plus x over 1 minus x equals t minus 3 over t plus 3. Here we have the three results. In this formula, we replace all x in terms of t. The first part, as we defined, is t. That's f of t, 3 plus x over 1 minus x equals t minus 3 over t plus 1. The right-hand side x equals 3 plus t over 1 minus t. This is the first result. Similarly, we define t equals 3 plus x over 1 minus x, the inside part. Here is t. Solving this equation for x, we have x equals t minus 3 divided by t plus 1. Rewrite x minus 3 over x plus 1 in terms of t, which is 3 plus t over 1 minus t. Therefore, we have the second result. X minus 3 over x plus 1 equals 3 plus t over 1 minus t. 3 plus x over 1 minus t as we defined, which is t. The right-hand side x equals t minus 3 over t plus 1. We summarize the two results here. Equation 1 plus equation 2. The sum of the left-hand sides, we have 2 f of t. We have f of t minus 3 over t plus 1. F of 3 plus t over 1 minus t. The sum of the right-hand sides equals 3 plus t over 1 minus t plus t minus 3 over t plus 1. We simplify the both sides we have. this part based on the given equation. If we replace t by x, this is x. Now it's t. The sum of the first two terms equals t plus 2f of t. Simplify the right-hand side. We have 8t over 1 minus t squared. Solving this equation for f of t. Therefore, we have f of t equals 4t over 1 minus t squared minus t over 2. Rewrite this result in terms of x. Therefore, we have f of x equals 4x over 1 minus x squared minus x over 2. This is the general formula for the function of f of x. That's all. Thanks for watching and see you next time.